factorization. Find the zeros of 4s square minus 4s plus 1. So we have to find the zeros, we have to find the roots. Zeros and roots both are same. So to find the zeros, first you check that the given quadratic expression is in standard form or not. So what is the standard form? Ax square plus bx plus c. So this is a standard form. Here 4s square minus 4s plus 1, it is in standard form. So here we have to find the zeros. The first step is multiply the coefficient of s square with the constant term. So that is 4 is the coefficient of s square and here is the constant term is 1. So if you multiply these two, 4 into 1 will be 4. So this is the coefficient of s square here. This is the constant term. I am multiplying both. The result is 4. Okay. Now I am adding these two, 4 and 1. After addition, I am getting a result is 5. But in the middle, it is 4 is there. Okay. 4 minus 1 is nothing but 3. In the middle, 4 is there. It is not equal to, the result is not equal to middle one. So now what I have to do? I have to see other factors of 4. 4 into 1, we are getting 4. So here the result is 4. We have to see other factors of 4. In which table 4 is available? One is 1 into 4 is 4. 2 into 2 is 4, again 4 into 1 is 4. These are all the possible factors of 4. So now I am take 2 into 2 is 4. So this is another factor of 4. Add these two, 2 plus 2 is nothing but 4. Middle term is also 4 here. So now what I can do, I can write minus 4s as minus 2s minus 2s plus 1 is the constant term. So in the middle minus 4 is there, minus 2 minus 2 is nothing but minus 4. Here I am splitting the middle term as minus 2s minus 2s. The result will be same, minus 2 minus 2. The addition of minus 2 minus 2 will give you minus 4. After that you see any common terms. So here 4s square can be written as, 4 can be written as 2 into 2, s can be written as s into s. The second term is minus 2s, 2 into s we can write. Here we can see minus 2s again, third term, 2 into s we can write. So here 1 can be written as 1 into 1 for our convenience. In these two, in the first two terms, see the common terms. Here 2 is the common thing in both. S is also common in both. Okay. Here you write 2s into 1. here also you write 2s into 1. So if you multiply with 1, the value will not change. Okay. The second, what is the common thing? 1 is a common thing. So you write the common things outside. 2s we are writing outside. So remaining, what is left without circle? 2 here. Here s. Minus is a symbol. Keep that minus sign here. So without circle 1 is there. So we completed. In these two, common terms are written outside. After that, without circle, terms are written here. Numbers 2 is there, s is there, minus 1. Nothing is common means here 1 is the common thing. That is, we have to understand. So in these two, minus 1 is a common thing, 2s. So here plus symbol is there, but minus into minus will be plus. Minus into minus will be plus. Symbol is changing. So again 1. So again you see here 2s minus 1. 2s minus 1 is the common thing. So write that 2s minus 1 as a common factor. What is left remaining? Here 2s is left. Here minus 1 is left. So one time you make 2s minus 1 equal to 0. 2s minus 1 is equal to 0. If a into b equal to 0, it may be a equal to 0 or b equal to 0. So here 2s minus 1 equal to 0, you send that 1 to right side, transposing rule, minus 1 becomes plus 1. So again 2, it is in multiplication with s, 2 goes to division. So the answer is 1/2. Here also same, 1/2. Therefore the roots are 1/2, 1/2. These are the zeros. So you try this question, 3x square minus x minus 4, 6x square minus 3 minus 7x. If see here, 6x square minus 3 minus 7x. So first you change it into standard form, 6x square minus 7x minus 3. Now it is in standard form, ax square plus bx plus c. Now you can solve the problem.